Hello, good day everyone. I'm Tevs. Welcome back to this channel. This next repair is another 32 inches Samsung LED TV. It's not turning on, and no standby light indicator. I'll show you how to repair it. If you are new to this channel and just a beginner at repairing TV and other electronic appliances, you are in the right channel. So never forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you will never miss a video like this. So let's get started. The TV is no power, so let's start to test the main fuse. The fuse is okay. Now let's measure the secondary voltages. The cathode of these diodes is the main output of this power supply. This diode measures about 1.8 volts, and these two diode measures 26 volts. Let's try the analog multimeter. The voltage is pulsing even though I did not yet plug the main. Let's try to disconnect it from the main board and then try to measure the voltage again. The voltage is still not normal. Did you see how many voltage was measured by the digital meter? Let's try the analog multimeter. It measures more than 5 volts. The digital doesn't measure it. That's why I still use an analog meter. Let's unscrew the power supply board and remove it to see the other side. Thanks again to this powered screwdriver Mr. Jeff Edwards, It is very useful. This is the 26 volts that I measure lately. Let's measure it again. It's 26 volts. This should be 12 volts, it is overvoltage. And this is the pulsing voltage that my digital multimeter can't measure the voltage. I don't know if the other expensive brand is able to measure it. Let's try again the analog multimeter. You can see the voltage is pulsing about 6 volts or more. It's much better to use both digital and analog for measuring such that kind of voltage behavior. Always make sure that the main capacitor is discharged before testing the primary components. The overvoltage is usually the problem is the optocoupler or the error amp. But before we test the optocoupler and the error amp, let's first see where the optocoupler is connected to the primary side. Let's trace the optocoupler line. I'll be honest with all of you, at the beginning of this repair, I already detect the problem. I just reenact it for you to see how I trace it. The optocoupler pin 3 is going to pin 2 of the PWM IC driver. And pin 4 is not connected to pin 1 of the PWM IC driver. And this should be connected to the ground. Let's clean it. The disconnected line is not visible. Let's scrub it to see the disconnected line. It's clear that the trace is disconnected. Let's reconnect it. The line is connected now. Let's try it. It measures steady at 5.3 volts now. And the 26 volts before is now 12.8 volts now. Putting back the power supply and reconnecting the main board. Looks working now.
A few moments later.
The TV is working great. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video. If you do, so never forget to like and subscribe. And hit the notification bell to keep you updated. Once again, I'm Tefs. See you again next time. Bye for now.